Hi, I'm Alia Shawkat. I got involved with the Mew Mew Tale number 17, Shaku Maku. Haley and I met in New York through friends at some movie premiere party or something, and got along swimmingly. And then we were always friends, and then she texted me one day and said, "Do you speak Arabic?" And I said, "Shwaya," which means a little bit in Arabic, because the truth is I don't speak enough. But she was like, "All right, that's all I need to know. A little bit's fine." And then I felt like a couple of weeks passed, and she's like, "I want to get together. I want to talk to you about something." And she kind of told me about this role-playing thing and how, you know, it's actually real for armies to practice. And I thought it was fascinating. And then she just casually kind of was like, "So, imagine you're a role player. You're this girl. She's an actress. She's Iraqi." And it was just such a fun story. I think she told me in the amount of time of a cab ride. And I was like, "Are you asking me to do it? Because I would love to." I was like, "Otherwise, it sounds cool. I wish you luck." And she was like, "Yeah, I'm going to write a draft and, you know, send it to you." And she did. And I think it's hilarious. Yeah, well, the context of this film is, you know, definitely personal in some way. I've never actually been to Baghdad, but my father is from there. And when I just even found out about this role-playing system, I thought it was so interesting. I was like, right, they're reenacting what an Arab city would be like with actors pretending to be civilians and amputees pretending to be hurt, and all to create a simulation so they feel prepared when they get out there. Which, I've never been to war, but I can't imagine a simulation is necessarily anywhere similar to it. But I guess a little bit, you know, helps. It's strange. When I told my father he's actually going to visit today, he was really interested. He really wanted to see, because he hasn't been back to Baghdad since he was in his, early 30s. It's strange. It's kind of like a role I've always hope to play, especially an actress who kind of wants it too much. I can relate to that part, being a desperate actress myself. But then on top of that, just being able to speak Arabic and, you know, learning how to do the traditional hijab and the style and the tradition of it all, and being able to speak Arabic with people, I feel really lucky to be able to connect to my heritage in that way. And then also to bring some comedy kind of and light in it. Yeah, it's been a really unique experience. It's kind of all these themes that I've always wanted to explore, especially lately in, you know, show business, if you will, and filmmaking. People are taking it more seriously by actually hiring people of the proper descent to play their roles, which has always seemed like a foreign idea. So it's refreshing and also nice to be able to play a role almost because I'm half Iraqi. And yet there's also comments where they're like, "Well, if you're Iraqi, why do you have so many freckles?" And she kind of rolls her eyes like she's not authentic enough. And it's, I think it's a really smart comment on how we try to portray reality. And also this preparation for something that's so much more severe than any kind of reenactment could be. Well, I've been acting for 20 years now. I've been very lucky. I love all the jobs I've done and I'm working consistently. So it's, you know, I'm very appreciative of it. But there's definitely been a transition, you know, in Hollywood and in the world of kind of having, not only women, but then, you know, women of color, obviously, and different ethnicities to be in more of a power position. And again, stories that are actually authentic. So to me, in the last couple of years, I've been trying to write more and wanting to make things that are authentic to my heritage and to my backstory and to Arabs in general, trying to give them a different perspective on film. And then, I've worked with a lot of great male directors, but lately my interests and just my connections on personal relationships and creatively have been with women. And I really like being on sets that are like that. There's just a different form of communication and just the balance of the numbers are really off. So I'm really all about trying to encourage, if I'm in any position to help, bringing more women to work with me and hoping that there's somebody up there to help me. So it's kind of a nice circle that I hope continues. And I just feel like the stories have a certain sensibility to them that I feel like telling lately. Yes, I've seen a handful of the tales. I've had a couple friends who've been in them and some who've directed. I think it's an amazing thing you guys started, especially the women's tales and bringing... I remember when Haley was telling me about this, she was listing off some of the directors and talking about how Agnes Varda did one, and I was just like, wow, what amazing company we get to be in. I felt really honored. And I think it's really neat, too, that this line folds so well into this story. So it's like being appropriate and chic in this kind of like Muslim garb is like is really perfect. It really like fits the tone of the story really well.